she I will be brave. I will not let anything take away standing in for us. Oh, me, every breath, every hour has come to this. One step, one step.
wedding day?
I do.
Today is a celebration of love and commitment, of friendship, of family, and of two people who are in it forever. Let us bow our heads and pray. Lord, we thank you for gathering everyone here today. We ask you that you help Jonathan and Sarah to remember the strong love that they share, to work that love into practical things, so that nothing can divide them. May their love always inspire them to be kind in their words, considerate of others, and concerned for the other's needs and wishes. Increase their faith and trust in you. Bless their marriage with peace and happiness, and make their love fruitful for your glory and their joy, both here on earth and in eternity. Amen. You don't need a ceremony to have a marriage. And when you think about it, the whole thing is kind of weird, right? You're standing on a stage, looking fancy, holding flowers, and being stared at by pretty much everyone who has meant anything to you in the past 20 years. Why do we do it? The marriage ceremony has been an important feature across nearly every culture, religion, generation, and society. We have thousands of important moments that happen throughout our lives, but this one is regarded as one so critical, we acknowledge its special status by sharing it with others. Why this moment? Because despite all of our differences, love is what we all share. It's the great unifier, our one universal truth. And no matter who we are or where we come from, what we believe, we know this one thing: love is what we're doing right. That's why you're both here today. That's why we're all here, to watch you stand up here. We have all loved in our lifetime, and in this moment, we're reminded that the ability to love is the very best part of humanity. All of us here today have our own love story. Some are short, others long, some are unwritten, while others are just getting to the good part. There are chapters in our stories that are sad or disappointing, and others that are exciting and full of adventure. And that brings them here, a time to pause, look back, and smile at the moments that brought them here, and a time to look ahead at all the moments that are still to come. I'm here, we're all here, because we want these moments for you. We're here to hope with you, to support you, to be proud of you, and to remind you that love isn't happily ever after. Love is the experience of writing your story. It's not one moment, not even this moment, it's every moment. Big ones, like saying I love you, moving in together, getting engaged, mostly a million little ones that come in between. Falling asleep next to one another, making dinner together, spending holidays with your families, binge watching Netflix, or getting a big hug when you get home from work. These everyday moments fused together into one big experience. And even though this experience is so incredible, words fail us when we try to explain it. That's just the way love is. It's meant to be felt, not described. Even though love can look different from one person to the next, we all know it when we see it, and we see it here today. You fell in love by chance, but you're here today because you're making a choice. You both are choosing each other, someone who enhances you, who makes you think, makes you smile, makes your days brighter. You're about to make promises to each other that you intend to keep. You're going to vow to take care of each other, stand up for one another, find happiness in the other. There's a simple premise to each of these promises you vow. You're vowing to be here. You're teaming up and saying to the other, every experience I want to have, I want to have it. So with that said, Sarah, yes. I, Sarah, treat you, Jonathan, as my favorite person. To laugh with, to want to dance with, Christ tough moment.
The portion from life tough moment.
Be proud of you.
Be proud of you.
Grow old with you.
Grow old with you.
And find new reasons to love you every day.
Find new reasons to love you every day.
Now, Sarah and Jonathan, you promise to be each other's partners from this day forward. Will you bring out the best of one another, share your happiest moments together, and love each other absolutely for the rest of your lives, and for whatever may come next? You've both chosen to wear rings as a reminder of these promises. People often say wedding rings are a perfect circle, with no beginning and no end, but these rings did have a beginning. The stones were formed a long time ago, deep within the earth. Eventually, a series of lucky events caused them to rise through the surface. They were molded, cooled, and painstakingly polished. Something beautiful was made from raw elements. Love is like that. It comes from humble beginnings, and through a combination of work and effort, imperfect beings shape into something extraordinary. It's the process of making something beautiful where there was once nothing at all. As you look at these rings after the years, I hope you remember that you created something invaluable, and just as place the ring on Sarah's left hand and repeat these words. Sarah, today I give you all of me.
Sarah, today I give you all of me.
From this day forward, you are my life partner.
From this day forward, you are my life partner.
With this ring, I be wed.
With this ring, I be wed.
Sarah, please place the ring on Jonathan's left hand and repeat after me. Jonathan, today I give you all of me. From this day forward, you are my life partner. With this ring, I be wed. Sarah and Jonathan have written something from the heart to share today. Sarah, ladies first.
So much. You have been an inspiration for success since day one. When things start to get tough, I promise to never give up and always stand by your side. Even when we have our disagreements, I promise to always respect and value your point of view. I promise to always love and cherish you with all of my heart. I promise to love and treat your family as my own. I promise to always be the same person that you fell in love with. Thank you for choosing me.
Let this wedding ceremony remain as a treasure, memory, and a guide. May they always experience their breathless wonder, that status, out of all this world, you chose me. When life is done and the sun is setting, may they be found then as now, still hand in hand, still thanking thee for each other. Amen. You have both joined voluntarily in this ceremony of marriage and have been formally united as husband and wife. In the presence of your family and your friends. As you declared openly your clear intentions to be considered before all the world as a married couple and have exchanged rings and vows attesting thereto, it is my pleasure and honor to pronounce you husband and wife. So by the power vested in me by the state of Florida, I pronounce that you are husband and wife. Jonathan, you may kiss your bride. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jonathan Rodriguez.
Painted a picture of 65 years and one little life, more than many, more than sin that I do.
Set out on a narrow way many years ago, hoping I would find true love along the broken road. But I got lost a time or two, wiped my brow and kept pushing through. I couldn't see how every sign pointed straight to you. Every long lost dream led me to where you are. Others who broke my heart, they were lying. much I know is true. That God bless the broken road that led me straight to you. I spent just passing through. I'd like to have the time I lost and give it back to you. But you just smile and take my hand. You've been there, you understand. It's all part of a grander plan that is coming true. Every long lost dream led me to straight to you.
Step out this way and just kind of fill up all over here like this. You guys come on out of there, come on out the back and fill up this whole area right here. Come on back there, over here. Come on over here, there you go. Get away from the table because there's no food on the table. That's really what we need the table for. And there's no food right now, so let me go before, pasen por acá, and fill up this whole area. Make some room for Annette, and then you gotta come on down here. All right, this is good. All right, now listen, we're gonna introduce a bridal party here, and when we do, every name that gets sounded here today, you guys are gonna let off some noise. All right, does everybody know what booyah means? When I say, haga una booyah, in Latin, that means make some noise, all right? So if I say, haga una booyah! All right, now listen, when we make noise, it's not just a woo and let it go, all right? You gotta act like you mean it. So on the count of three, everybody make some noise. One, two, three. Feeling the love, people, feeling the love, and that's what I'm talking about. Señor Jesús, ¿estamos listos? All right, hold on a second. Now what we gotta do here first? We're gonna recognize a few people here first. All right. Now they're not on the list right now. All right. But I want to recognize them because they are here. These are the grandparents of the groom. Somebody make some noise for Jesus. Put them down. I don't want to put him on the spot. That's all right. We're good. All right, listen up, people. I'm about to introduce, first of all, let's welcome the parents of the bride, Anthony and Maria. Oh, we're going to get louder than that, people. There you go. They're feeling it. What? Yes. That's what I'm talking about. Please welcome the parents of the groom, Robert and Victoria. The lovely Chris, escorted by Johnny. Yeah! What, no action, Johnny? Oh! Oh, what a surprise. Anthony and Ashley. Anthony, the mild, distinguished gentleman.
Better be doing some of that little later.
Please welcome Alex, Ashley, and Shayla. He got two. Make some noise, people.
Alex, you are the bum. You are my hero.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, certainly two very important people of our bridal party today. That would be the best man and maid of honor. Please help me welcome Mark and Sarah. Come on, make some noise, man. That was too quick, Mark and Sarah. You gotta bring it back to the middle of the dance floor. Bring it back to the middle.
Here today.
I want you to make some noise for them truly out there because they definitely deserve it. They are the new Mr. and Mrs. Rodrigo! Yeah! Everybody walk towards the bride and groom. Well, you guys certainly look fabulous. All right. I want everybody to stay right there. No. Don't everybody move. Because there's a moment that's about to take place here. They're getting ready to perform not only for us, the first dance of this evening, but their first dance as husband and wife. Yes. Feel that love, ladies and gentlemen. Bless the broken road. Round of applause for the newlyweds, everybody.
I said I'm on a narrow way many years ago, hoping I would find true love along the broken road. But I got lost in time to wipe my brow and kept pushing through. I couldn't see how
this place, like there's nobody else civil world. I was enough for her not long ago. I was her number one, she told me so. And she still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything, life must go on. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father was me. Someday, but it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. After that beautiful woman with you, be the same freckle face kid that I knew, one that I read all those fairy tales to. Tucked in the bed all those nights, and I knew the first time I saw you with her, it was only a matter of time. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she put a smile at me, but it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first.
Anthony, we want you to step forward. Come on over and hug your dad. Come on and hug the family. Jonathan, I want you to step forward. Come on over, Jonathan.
That's why I didn't step up.
I got your back, my baby. Anthem, I want you to hug your new son-in-law.
Smiles over you.
Jonathan, your father-in-law. Welcome to the family, Jonathan. Let's give all of them a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Jonathan, I want you to go on over and grab the hand of that lovely young lady that you've been standing by for a little while here, because this is a special day for mom to share with her son on his wedding day. My wish.
You choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking until you find a window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything,
every chance you get, though you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give.
ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we're going to ask everybody to go ahead and take your seats in just a moment. We are going to be toasting this wonderful couple here. Everybody have a glass of champagne in front. Everybody got the glass. All right. We're going to ask the lovely Sarah, our maid of honor, to bring her glass of champagne up so she can toast our bride and groom. Hey, oh, you want some coming down or is it?
Couple. I spent a lot of my time when she was down here with Sarah, and we got to spend a lot of time together, and I think that your relationship is a lot of people's goals, and even myself looked up to you guys in your relationship, and I love you guys. Thank you for everyone coming. Thank you for having me be your maid of honor. And thank you for sharing time, because I take a lot of her time. I know. But just thank you, and I wish the best. I know I don't have to wish the best, because I know you guys will be the best.
All right, big smile right here. Come up a little bit, there you go. Nice picture.
All right, let's go ahead and give her a big round of applause, everybody. All right, Mark, our best man, please make your way up to the microphone.
somebody drop a hot 16. It's 2017, so I did it on the phone.
Smart.
Oh shit, it won't let me in.
Karina, where's your fingerprint? Just kidding.
Need a beat? Need a beat? Oh, you need?
No. I was just kidding. All right, so I left my glasses in the car so y'all can see me today. First of all, I want to thank everybody who came today and made it possible. You know, I'm especially glad to be here on this occasion to celebrate this wonderful day, my brother. We've been friends for about 15 years. Woo-hoo! Since kids playing video games, you know.
Hey.
To shooting cars, passing on the roof, you know, paintball guns, you know, things happen, things change. But I'm truly grateful I had a friend like him growing up. We really understood one another. He's the type of person to get the shirt right off his back with no hesitation. Really put people first before himself, and of course, very proper. That must have been that very good Winn-Dixie customer service training. One thing I always give you credit for is putting your foot forward and paving a way and striving in what you believe in. There's probably not another person in this room that knows you better than me, maybe Sarah, who looks beautiful today.
Thank you.
Can we get a round of applause? Sarah, you really have done something to John that nobody has ever done, brought something great out of him. He's truly the best for him. You know, I've seen this boy grow into a man. He turned into a man today, didn't he? I want you both to know I'm very happy for you guys and proud of what you guys have accomplished and look to accomplish in the years to come. With that being said, I'm going to leave you guys with this quote. It says, how do you know when she's the one? Oh, no. Marriage is not about finding the person you can live with. It's about finding the person you can't live without. My friend has found that person. Here's to a lifetime of happiness and love for John and Sarah. Hey, Mark, here, we're gonna get a cool photo here, man. All right, everybody raise your glasses. Everybody raise your glasses up in the air. On the count of three, one big salute. One, two, three. All right. Well, hey, Jonathan's like, I've been dying to hit this something, man. Come on, bro. All right, where's Victoria? No. Victoria. Okay, Victoria, if you could lead us off with the blessing of the dinner today, whatever you do. All right?
Thank you, Lord.
All right.
Thank you, Lord, for bringing Jonathan and Sarah together. I'd like to thank you for having everyone here today, especially my mom and my dad, because I know they want to be here today.
Yeah. All right.
We'd also like to thank you.
I ask that we all bow our heads, please. Dear Lord, we are so grateful for everything you are doing for us. You know I don't deserve half the things you have done for me. Thank you for being our strength in these difficult times. But I know your plan never fails. I know things are going to get easier. And you've never let us down. We ask that you bless this food that we're about to eat on this lovely evening. And I ask that you give my family, which includes Sarah's family, the peace and understanding of God's plan over the next couple days. In Jesus' name we pray, and we all said amen.
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 Jonathan, go give your mama a hug. Hello.
This is a grip. This is a grip.
He just called me the preacher lady.
Now that gets all backwards.
Jonathan, raise one hand up!
You guys are supposed to be the guys that have his back all the time.
And his back side.
I'm about to ruin the image of the style that you used to. I look funny, but y'all are making money. See, so y'all want my heart, you're ready for me. I got the rhyme. My name is Humpty, pronounced with my auntie. Your name is all I like to bump me. And all I'm up to the top 10, it's a lot to bump me. I'm not as tall as y'all, and it's like Humpty Dumpty. You're gonna fall when the stereos bump me. I like the knob, I like when it's funky or spunky. I like my homie to whack me, I'm sick of this. Straight gangsta the Mac, but sometimes I get ridiculous. I leave your body crackers and you're licorice. Now you're fat girl, come here, are you ticklish? Yeah, I got you fat. And never stop me from getting busy, I'm a freak. I like the girls with the boom. I once got busy in a Burger King bathroom. I'm crazy, allow me to amaze thee. They say I'm ugly, but I just don't faze me. I'm still getting in the girls' pants, and I even got my own dance.
Put your hands in the air, come on.
That's how I get things quick, and you stay. I'm gonna be custom
you.